Welcome back after a few cool and cloudy days. How good was it to see that sunshine back again today? Circular Quay sparkling under the blue skies. The jacarandas out early this year, bringing a splash of purple to First Fleet Park. Top temperatures warming up again. Most of our western suburbs hitting 26 degrees today, 25 in Richmond and Campbelltown. The city stopping at 23, but felt a few degrees cooler thanks to those moderate to fresh northeasterlies. Across New South Wales, some isolated showers over the north coast, less than 5 millimetres for most. Nambucca Heads on the mid-north coast getting a good soaking with 20 millimetres recorded so far. Top temperatures well below average in that region. Coffs only making it to 21. That is 7 degrees colder than usual for this time of year. Dry and mostly sunny elsewhere. Broken Hill and Bourke both making it into the 30s. A cold front brushing the south of our state, bringing a gusty, southerly change to the southern coast. That system pushing northwards tomorrow and Saturday. Onshore winds bringing showers and storms to northeastern New South Wales, while a high will keep much of our state clear and dry. A fine day ahead for Brisbane, heading for a top of 25 degrees. Ditto for Canberra, partly cloudy and 25. A cooler 17 degrees in Melbourne, sunny and 21 for Adelaide, and Perth getting up to 30 degrees. Back home to New South Wales, isolated showers along the coast, generally less than 5 millimetres. There's also the chance of thunderstorms about the central coast and ranges, but it will be dry west of the ranges. Top temperatures remaining below average in the northeast and far southwest. A warm spring day for Dubbo, hitting 30, 27 in Mudgee and Griffith, and 22 to 26 along the coast. Sydney will be mostly fine, partly cloudy skies with a slight chance of a shower, most likely at night. There is also the chance of a thunderstorm. The Bureau only expecting up to a millimetre. Temperatures much like today, reaching 25 to 27 in our west and 24 for the city after a low of 15, 11 to 13 in our west. The rain clouds sticking around on Saturday with a shower or two in the morning, a cooler 20 degrees, then creeping up again on Sunday, 22 under cloudy skies. Next week, we could be in for some decent rainfall, up to 9 millimetres on Monday, 7 on Tuesday, and those showers then easing but hanging around until Thursday. A similar forecast for our west, a cool start to the weekend, not even making the 20s with a shower or two, cloudy and 23 on Sunday, then showers for the next 4 days, warming up to 26 by Thursday. So a bit of everything coming our way over the next week, Georgie.
Hello again. It ended up being a beautiful day in Melbourne with plenty of sunshine and fairly calm conditions during the afternoon. But it was an extremely windy morning. Northerlies gusted up to 76 kilometres an hour at Tullamarine around 5:30 this morning. Essendon and St Kilda both clocked 72. Quite a few suburbs climbed up into the low 20s before the winds switched around to southwesterlies. Didn't do too much damage though, dropping just a few degrees. The state southwest felt the cool change first as that trough moved through. So while Warrnambool only made it to 16 degrees, it was 13 degrees warmer than that in the Mallee. Looking further afield, and conditions are easing near the Queensland coast after severe storms lashed the area over the past 48 hours. More than 350,000 lightning strikes were detected yesterday afternoon south of Rockhampton, along with heavy rain and flash flooding. Storms have triggered more than 70 millimetres in Brisbane. But it will get the chance to dry out tomorrow with a partly cloudy top of 25. Canberra also heading for 25 degrees, and Perth should reach 30 for the first time since April. Back home, there'll be patches of fog and frost in the morning as minimums dip to single figures across the board, then heading to the low to mid-20s for places north of the ranges. Cooler and cloudier through the south with a possible shower or two, just a millimetre if anything, and mostly 17 degrees. Here in Melbourne, a very chilly low of 2 on the way for Coldstream before a partly cloudy top of 17. Avalon will climb even higher, up to 19. For Geelong, down to 5 degrees overnight, then overcast and 18. The city should dip to a low of 6 and a top of 17 with plenty of sunshine, especially through the morning. For our weekend, Saturday, partly cloudy and 18. For the Melbourne Marathon on Sunday, a low of 7 and a mostly sunny 25 degrees. Monday, 21 with a light shower. A sunny Tuesday and a top of 24. Up to 26 on Wednesday with showers and the chance of a storm. We could also see a storm on Thursday. Showers and 21. Tonight, a low of 6 under clear skies. We'll have a sunny morning, a few clouds through the afternoon and a top of 17 degrees under much calmer conditions.
It'll start out with a mostly fine Friday, Melissa. We could see just a morning shower, and I'm afraid there are a couple of showers later into the weekend and early next week, but nothing compared to what we've received over the past 48 hours, those widespread falls of 100 to 150 millimetres. Let me show you how the day unfolded with the radar. Just a quick look today of the heaviest showers between Brizzy and the Sunshine Coast. So it was the northern side compared to yesterday on the Gold Coast, but all dried up and looking relatively clear this evening. Right now in Brizzy, we've got 20 degrees as we take a look at temperatures across southeast Queensland. Now, they were below average across majority of the suburbs today due to those gusty southerly winds. Temperatures mainly low 20s. Caboolture, one of the coolest places, just 22 degrees. Well, here in the city, 24, and that was the maximum shared with just a few suburbs today. The weather map, showers and storms over the northwest of the country, extending down through the interior and into South Australia tomorrow. Moisture-laden winds will continue to deliver showers to parts of eastern Queensland. For northeast New South Wales, the far tropics and also western Tassie we'll see a bit tomorrow. Interstate, we're looking at a sunny day in Perth and Adelaide, partly cloudy for Melbourne. A shower or two on the way for Hobart and Sydney, hot and sunny in Alice Springs and Darwin, temperatures sort of mid to high 30s. Queensland tomorrow, partly cloudy. It'll be quite warm with a possible shower for the north coast up around Cairns, also Townsville. The lower Burdekin, central coast, Capricorn, also just partly cloudy, along with the Wide Bay and Burnett with a possible shower. Sunny and dry inland, we're looking at mid 30s for Mount Isa and Longreach, partly cloudy in Roma and 29 degrees. So Friday in the southeast, some early morning fog patches, followed by a partly cloudy day. The best chance of a shower will be along the coastal fringe and out around the Bay Islands. Light to moderate easterly winds. Overnight temperatures 11 to 17. Daytime temperatures ranging from mid-20s on the coast and reaching high 20s inland. Moreton Bay, south-east to easterlies, 10 to 15 knots, a lot lighter than today. The sea's around a metre. Brisbane, chance of a morning shower only, followed by a partly cloudy day, the low of 16 and a high of 25. Your outlook, Saturday, 27, that'll be the warmest day with a late shower possible. Sunday, a shower likely, and then a few showers across Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday with mid-20s. Ipswich, Saturday, 29, a possible late shower. Cloudy Sunday, just the chance of a shower and a couple of showers Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. The Goldie, Saturday, 25, a late shower, a shower or two on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, I'm afraid. The Sunshine Coast, partly cloudy Saturday, just the chance of a shower, then a shower or two returning for Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Temperatures expected to reach the mid-20s each day. So not a lot of rain in it, but still a couple of light showers later in the weekend. Enjoy your Friday.
Hello again. It is so cool here at the National Railway Museum. You really do feel like you have actually travelled back in time when you're walking along the platforms here with the old trains. And of course, you can expect all of this at times by a lot more on the weekend with the expo happening here. There'll be old trains and buses and police and emergency vehicles. So if anyone in your family, particularly the kids, are into vehicles, then definitely worth checking that out. Today we had lots of sunny weather around Adelaide. We had that top in the low 20s, and right now it's actually cooled off quite a bit. We're sitting in the mid-teens in the city at the moment. So across the suburbs around Adelaide today, plenty of sunshine for the kids on school holiday. No matter what you've been up to. We had 21 degrees at Glenelg and at Norlunga it was 20. Not a drop in the gauges across South Australia today. We reached 30 at Roxby Downs and 24 at Port Augusta and Port Pirie. Further south, temperatures tapered off to 18 degrees at Victor Harbour and Mount Gambier. There is a high pressure system on the charts there. It's just floating across, and as it continues to move east, things will warm up over the weekend and beyond. Interstate tomorrow, Brisbane and Sydney and Canberra are all sitting pretty easily in the mid-20s, while Melbourne and Hobart are on the cooler side with 17 degrees each. Back to South Australia and some possible showers in the far west, but most areas are looking pretty sunny, including Port Augusta with 25 and Whyalla with 20. And the chance of a light morning shower about the lower southeast coast and some cold mornings in the mix there too. Narracourt and Victor Harbour both going for 18 degrees. On metro waters, south to southeasterlies, 10 to 15 knots, reaching 20 knots north of Grange in the late afternoon. And no shortage of sunshine on tomorrow's forecast around the Adelaide suburbs, with temperatures pretty similar today, sitting nice and easily in the low 20s. In the city, it is a sunny 21 degrees with an overnight low of around 8 degrees for tonight. After that, over the weekend, we're up into the mid-20s for Saturday and Sunday, and even up to 30 degrees by next week. And Kader, I did see that the Heritage Expo features buses that have been made in the 1980s. I was made in the 1980s. I think that makes me a Heritage weather presenter, and I think that makes you a Heritage newsreader.